Welcome to the Seacoast Charter School virtual winter concert of 2021. We're not using the word annual because this is not going to be an annual event. We are determined.
Yes, to not.
If you're watching this the night of the premiere, this means we are one day away from February break, which means we've made it through 6 months of school, which means when we come back on March 1st, we only have less than 4 months of school left. It reminds me of the Talking Heads song. You may ask yourself, well, how did we get here? I have no idea. It has been such a whirlwind, and I know I'm speaking for every teacher and staff member and parent and student right now.
Absolutely.
But we've made it for 6 months. We can make it for four more.
Around the music room, we refer to the 80-20 rule a whole lot, which means the first 80% of your project takes 20% of your energy, while the last 20% of the project takes 80% of your energy. So we don't know what's going to happen in the next 4 months. We don't know what it will look like, but it's a process. But this is the last 20% of the year, so it'll take 80% of our energy.
Exactly. So we need to dig deep and get through this, but also have a good time, right? It's going to be a process. What we do at the charter school is all about process. It's what we do, it's what we teach, it's the foundation of our school, it's the mission of our school, and we use a lot of names to describe the process, and that's the design process, the creative process, the artistic process, the problem-solving process. We have never been really able to decide on which process we want to call it, and the point is we want our students to understand how to get from point A to point Z. And it doesn't matter if you're creating a piece of art, solving a math problem, working on a 10-page paper, figuring out how to teach remote, then hybrid, then remote, then hybrid, then remote again. Did I miss anything?
Nope, that's it. That's cut.
So far, that's it. And how to put on a virtual strings concert. We went through this process last year, and when somebody asked us in the one of the general music classes whether we were going to do a concert this year, or a virtual concert, Emily and I answered at the same time. My answer was no, I think it's too much. And Emily's was...
Yes, of course. You're crazy. Same wavelength. Yeah.
So I figured after the last one, Emily was done.
No way, let's do it. It's tradition. Yeah. Everything in this school is about tradition. We try to make it tradition, and like everything that we do is like the creative process, and the concerts is part of that. So of course we have to.
So what did the process look like to get to this point of having an actual video with everybody's videos combined, thanks to Emily again? For me, the fifth and sixth graders didn't have strings class the first semester because I was working with the seventh and eighth graders. So I only have had them remotely, and the fifth graders have never even had me as a teacher before. They've only known me as the mean teacher during strings concert rehearsal week. And I don't know what they know me as now, but I didn't know what their level of playing, their personalities, but it's been so fun hanging out with them on Zoom in small groups and getting to know them and playing music with them.
Right, and for me, I had the fifth and sixth grade for the first trimester, so that was kind of weird for them because they're used to having Mary. The fifth graders are used to having me, but now it's kind of confusing. And we have some beginners in this concert that have been remote all along, so they have learned to play their instrument strictly over the internet. And the first trimester, I was making lots of videos, so they've learned through a video to learn how to play in the concert tonight. So it's a little crazy, and we've got our hybrid string players here, and it's just been back and forth and back and forth, so there's been so much hard work putting this concert that you're going to see tonight together.
So what does a Zoom strings class look like? Well, we'll tell you. First, students are supposed to show up and be set up and tuned for their class, and how much of the time does that actually happen? And then we move on to actually tuning the instruments over the internet. Emily and I have gotten really good at saying, turn the tuner two times to the right. Two more. Are you sure you're turning the right tuner?
I always
really
said,
turn it.
I say turn it towards your door. No, turn it towards your window.
Oh, that's a good one.
Right.
And so what we would do is Emily and I would be unmuted. The students would mute and they'd play along with us.
Because of course you cannot play music over Zoom because it echoes and delays and it's really bad. So we have to do class like that to play together.
Yeah. And then a lot of times we have to share our screen with the students because they haven't printed the music out because they don't have a printer or they're out of ink. So, and actually that's been kind of an advantage for both of us because then we could really point out things on the music.
Yes, I love zooming in. I like this note right here. This one.
So to get to the concert videos, my students had check-in videos they had to do along the way. And so we created a bunch of play-alongs for each of the instruments, for each of the songs. This brings us to the final concert video, which is a whole process in itself. It's way more stressful than a live performance. Even doing this video right now in front of a camera, and just Emily and Stretch,
right,
is more nerve-wracking than standing up in front of 600 people and talking.
Exactly.
But when you do your video, you have the mental game of numerous restarts because you get to a certain point of the recording and you mess up. You get to the end and you can feel like you're almost at the end, don't mess up. You mess up and then you have to do it again. I actually can see in students' videos when they're getting close to the end, I see them tense up a little bit and they stop breathing. And I know how stressful it is to do these recordings because I've made a lot of them for the strings concert, for general music. And in fact, I sent an play along to the cellos for the Sahara Crossing video that was supposed to be for the final video, and I got an email from one of the players saying, should we still practice along with the recording you sent where you mess up? And I wrote back, moi? Mess up? Where? She said, the part at the end where you scream. So that's what I sent out to my cello players to play for their final video. Luckily, they did not do that. But I could feel myself when I would get to close to the end of that of Sahara Crossing, I'd start with, here we go, here's the transition, don't mess up because you're right there.
That's why you screamed, right?
Yeah, that's why I screamed. Messed up and then we but screamed. I didn't swear. Yay. And then you have when you get your final video, you think you're done, and then your teacher asks you to do the video again because the sound didn't come through. Or the angle, we couldn't see your face in the video.
Or you forgot to play with the recording. Where's the headphones?
So then you had to go through the whole thing again. But by that time, you'd practiced so many times that it was not too bad,
fine.
Hopefully. But the big thing really is just missing that feeling of playing together as a group. I mean, that's what it is all about with music and the sound when you're all playing together, the fun of being with your friends, the excitement of the concert, getting to dress up. You know, and that's why we play music and why we teach it, is that feeling when the music's flowing, whether, and I always equate it to something like dancing or surfing or skiing, when everything's just clicking, it feels so good, you're not thinking about what you're doing, right? That's what we're trying to teach students, and sometimes reading black dots on a page is just a means to the end. That's not our primary focus.
And even though that we're remote and you're not here in the room with us all set up and practicing all week, it's still an important accomplishment. Like, you still feel super awesome because you did all of this work, even though it's been in your living room or in your bedroom. You've done all this work, and here we are at the concert, and you're like, ugh, look at all this work I did, and now you get to see it all compiled together.
Yes, so if you turn in a video for this concert, you have made it from A to Z. So even though we don't get to do a live performance, this process is still so important. It's such a feeling of pride and accomplishment when you finally finish it. And I got an email from a student when I gave feedback to his about his video, and he said, thank you so much, I love playing the cello and I will keep working at it. I especially love playing in the concerts. Although we don't have an in-person concert, I'm still very excited for the digital one. I can't wait until I get to watch it.
You're watching it.
Yep. And thank you so much for the positive feedback, and I'm really excited for the concert. So it's still really a big deal. I have to read one more email about the recording process that is just so funny. And it's from a mom that says, sorry if you get a bunch of recordings. I had problems uploading. His earpiece kept falling out and interrupting, so I used duct tape to hold it to his ear. Yes, duct tape. Ha ha, he was a trooper. Use number 10,001 for duct tape. Hope that gives you a laugh. P.S. Not fun for him when I took it off. And we have a picture of it, too.
Yes.
So the process for Emily and I have been to not only make the recordings, get everything organized, we have had to try to explain the process of what it's like to actually record your video, listen to it on your headphones, one headphone off, so have somebody recording you, organizing the videos alone.
So long. Oh my goodness, right? Just tell, who is this? Okay, what song are they playing? And so much.
There's so many videos to watch. Then you get to watch them.
Yay.
Then give feedback. And the amount of emails we give is unbelievable.
So many emails, but it's okay because it makes it all worth it. But so many.
Everything takes longer to do, but the fact is we got to do it. We can
right.
do it. So that's
yes.
really awesome.
That's the point.
But I always think about strings at the beginning of the semester or the beginning of the year, kind of like a marathon, right? We have all this time, so we just kind of pace ourselves. And then it's like, okay, time to give out the concert music. So now it's kind of like a 13K, so we're like picking up a little speed, but we still have a long way to go, got to pace ourselves. Get closer, it becomes a 5K. Couple weeks closer, it becomes a 1 mile. 2 weeks into it, we're at the 400-yard dash. Last week, it's the 50-yard dash.
Woo!
At high speeds, high energy, everything you got.
Right.
But now we are at the finish line.
Woohoo!
We made it.
Good job, everybody.
Which leads us to the first song.
Woohoo! So the first group you're going to see is the Beginning Strings group, and they are going to play their three songs that they usually play for their winter concert. If you have been to our winter concerts before, you know they are always playing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, French Folk Song, and Shortening Bread, so here they are.
Thank you.
beginners. Let's have a hit. So, speaking of Twinkle, the kids you're going to see next play Twinkle in last winter's concert, and now they are considered returning players. So, in the returning group, we try to pick easier songs, but not too easy, right? So there's going to be a lot of interesting things you hear in this song, like F sharps and F naturals. We learned those little idiosyncrasies between those two different tones. Or you're going to hear the hook, which is the melody that shows up all throughout the piece. And I'm sure you'll be able to pick it out once you hear it.
It's played over and over.
Yes,
over.
You will just hum it after you hear it. And we also had things like chromatic runs and eighth notes and like low B flats and C naturals. So all kinds of stuff that we were learning. But they did an awesome job learning between hybrid learning or remote learning the whole time. So this song is called Strawberry Jam Session, but my Friday players call it Jam Jam. So enjoy Jam Jam.
To the group that has become known as the Strawberry Jammers, who did an awesome job on
Woo-hoo!
That song.
Nice job.
The next song is a Seacoast Charter School classic called Sahara Crossing, and it has a Middle Eastern kind of deserty feel, and it's based on something called the melodic minor, which is also something that not many young students learn about. And it includes a lot of things they have never seen before. Low ones, low twos, a dal segno, a coda, double stops, and of course we all know pizzicato. Yay. And arco. So whenever we play the song, I always tell the students to imagine riding a camel through the desert. And I tell you, it really takes the song from here to here when you have that mental image of what a song you're playing is trying to convey. So this is Sahara Crossing.
Thank you.
it for Sarah Cross. The next group you're going to see is the 7/8 Strings, who have been remote all year. They have never had an in-person class, and we've just recently started doing classes over Google Meets, and we've been co-teaching, and it's been on our Wednesday when we also co-teach 5/6 music and 3/4 music. So there's been so awesome co-teaching in this whole process.
It's been so fun. It's been such a luxury. And the way we would do that is Emily would play one part, so she'd play cello or viola, and I would play the violin part. Students would mute, and so they could hear both. It was even it was closer to an actual in-person class than our other remote classes that we taught separately. At one point, the violin players knew the song so much better than me, I actually had them play violin because I kept messing up. Because there's actually some complicated parts to this, because it has something called a compound meter time signature.
Right, so you're going to hear, we're going to start in 6/8. Then the next measure is in 3/4, and then the next measure is in 6/8, and it alternates all throughout the piece. And sometimes there's chunks where it just stays in 1 meter, and then it starts switching around again. So that's really complicated, but it sounds really cool. So enjoy Fiesta.
So let's hear it for the 7/8 players on Fiesta. Years ago, when we were smaller, we used to end our string concerts with the rock band because there was only one rock band. But since then, we've gotten a lot bigger and we have many rock bands. And unfortunately, we couldn't do a separate 7/8 concert, which we would normally be doing this time of year, but we will be doing one in the spring, so look for that. But we were able to get one band together for a filming in the music room. This year, Emily and I were really fortunate to get a modern band grant. In our minds, we think rock band, but if you think about our concerts, if you've seen them in the past, it's more than just your typical rock band instruments. We've had cellos and ukuleles. We've had auto harps and xylophones. We've had it all.
Right.
So the new term is modern band, so it includes everybody. And we got this through an organization called Little Kids Rock, who is also funded by Carlos Santana's Milagro Foundation in conjunction with the Department of Education. So this grant was huge. It included not just money to buy instruments, but training on composition and songwriting, and using a program called Soundtrap, which a lot of our students have started already using in 7th and 8th grade. And we also took a whole module on how to teach instruments, and a lot of the stuff can be used remotely, which is really huge. So we are super, super lucky. So I'm really excited to see them in the spring, but until then, enjoy 7 Nation Army.
Woo!
Taking their time right behind my
So let's give a round of applause for our eighth grade rock band. So that concludes the Seacoast Charter School Virtual Concert of 2021.
It's not annual, though.
Not annual. No. Did we make that point clear?
Not annual.
But before we leave, I want to share a poem with you that I learned in first grade that I still think about to this day when times get hard. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will.
When the road you're trudging seems all uphill.
When funds are low and the debts are high.
And you want to smile, but you have to sigh.
When care is pressing you down a bit.
Rest if you must,
but don't you quit!
Life is queer with its twists and turns, as everyone of us sometimes learns. And many a failure turns about when you might have one that you stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are. It may be near where you seem so far. Don't stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things get worse that you must not quit.
Woo! All right, have an awesome break, everybody. Yay. And we'll see you in March.
Happy concert!
Woohoo!